Hello, it's me.
Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. There was a huge announcement recently. Guess what? You can run DAX queries directly inside of Power BI Desktop with the new DAX Query View. And everybody knows Patrick loves him some DAX Studio and Tableau Editor. Not saying I'm gonna stop using those because there's still some features and capabilities and that's not quite in this DAX Query View, but this DAX Query View is nice. It allows me to stay in one place to write my DAX queries. Before we get into this, we gotta give a big shout out to Zoe Douglas for making this capability possible in Power BI Desktop. Thanks, Zoe. All right, enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Before you get started, this is a preview feature. So in the bottom right corner, you'll see the little settings gear. Click it, open up your options window and go to preview features and get it enabled, DAX Query View. Once it's enabled, you'll see a little option right here. Boof. This is it. When you get started, you should take a look at this ribbon view because this ribbon is really nice. You can format queries, you can comment and uncomment, you can find things, you can do a find and replace. You know, it's contextual. So if I click right here and choose a command palette, you can see other options and other things that you can do right here in the command palette. It's pretty nice. And just to get started, watch this. So if you, once you're in this view, you can choose a particular table. Let's use this calendar. I'm gonna click on the ellipsis here and you can see where it says quick queries. So many things have this new quick queries flyout menu, so I can choose show top 1000 rows. Go ahead and click it. Look at that. It writes the query for me and it runs the query. Maybe I want to see everything. Well, that's not a problem for this new query view. Evaluate. Look at that. Look at that. The IntelliSense is right there. If I hit the space bar or if I hit tab, it'll auto complete for me. Let me show you. So I'm going to go ahead and hit tab. Boom. Then I'm going to do a new line, put a little tick. There's all my tables. Press calendar, and then I'm gonna format this. Look at that. And I'm gonna run, boof, everything. There's my little grid view down here. You know what's great about this grid view? Then let's do something. Let's be a little adventurous. We're gonna open Excel. We're gonna open a new blank worksheet. I'm gonna go back to my DAX query view, click copy. Guess what? There's all my data. I ran a query, copied it, put it in Excel, because that's what everybody wants to do. Don't do that. Don't put data in Excel. Work with it in Power BI Desktop. Anyway, you definitely can do it. Let's get out of Excel. We don't know we want to save that. And you can see now, I just have one result set. If you want to write multiple queries, it's just like pages in a Power BI report. So here's query one, here's query two. I can add another query. I can give it a name. So I can say, this is the work in progress. When I close the desktop and save it, all these queries are kept and saved with the report. So what that means is if I'm writing multiple queries, I have multiple queries open and I save my report, the next time I come back, those queries are gonna be there. So if I'm working on defining measures or, you know, writing queries to do some analysis of my data, it stays with everything I'm doing in my PBIX file. Kinda nice. So let's say I wanna create a measure or modify an existing measure. I can go over here, watch this, I'm gonna do this. My measures, I also have quick queries, so I can evaluate a measure, boom. It runs it for me. That's not what I want. I also can say quick queries, define and evaluate. So it defines it. And maybe I want to modify this. Maybe, you know what? I don't want to include freight in this measure. Pay attention to what happens right there. I'm going to go ahead and delete this. Look at that. We get a little indication. Hey, something happened. Do you want to change this? Before we make a change, let's switch over to the model view. Let's take a look at the DAX for this. You see it includes freight. I'm gonna go right back over here. I'm gonna say update this. Hey, this can't be undone. I know what I'm doing. I'm a professional. Click confirm, go back to the model view. Boom, it's been updated. Oh, I made a mistake. That's all right. I remember what I did. We'll do that. Net sales, let's find freight. Go ahead and update it again. Just like that. Switch back to the model view. There is my measure. This is pretty nice. It makes it easy to work directly inside of Power BI Desktop and not toggling, you know, between multiple tools. What you can also do is maybe you want to see the statistics for a given table. So let's choose our product table. We're going to go right here and we're going to go to quick queries. We're going to say show column statistics. I'm going to click that and boom, it shows you things like minimum, maximum, distinct count, and it names them out for you. So for each one of the columns in your table, you kind of get some statistics, some information about each one of those columns. So you can know if there's null values in it, what's the minimum value, what's the maximum value. Now you may be thinking, well, Patrick, what if I want to go here and define a measure and create a brand new measure? Will it add that measure to the model for me? Come on, you think they didn't do that? Let me show you. We can update one. Obviously, we can create one. I have an old measure that I created over in DAX Studio. I'm gonna add a new one. All right, we're gonna call this lowest value. So we're gonna paste that in there. We're gonna format this up to make sure it's all nice and formatted. Look at there, look what it says, right? This measure doesn't exist. Pay attention to this data pane over here. I'm gonna say update this, yep, boom. You can see it definitely adds that measure to the list. So you can add measures, you can modify measures. And if you're using the measure and you hover, wait, let me show you, So see, I'm using this total sales amount in another measure. If I hover over it, guess what? It gives me the definition of the measure. All I need to do is hover over that measure and it gives me the definition of it. I can see the definition of that measure. There's so many little hidden nuggets built into this, but I'm not done. This is like a kid on Christmas. I have to show you one more thing, and I'm probably forgetting something because there's so many things, but check this out. So let's say I go over here and I create a quick table by year. And then what I'm gonna do is just add a measure to it. Let's just find some measures, add a measure. Okay, it creates this. So I'm gonna go to Performance Analyzer. I'm gonna start up Performance Analyzer. I'm gonna say refresh my visual. There's the execution of it. Look at this. Run in DAX Query View. So if I click it, guess what it does? It copies that query, creates a new query page for me, puts the query in the page, and it actually executes that query for me. Are you kidding me? Like I said, there's so many things that you can do with this new DAX Query View. I'm probably forgetting something. Send me a message and say, hey, you forgot to show this, and I will do an update, a follow-up to talk about this even more. What do you think? Have you used this new query view? Do you plan on using it? I know I am. If you have any questions, if you have any comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to know more about data modeling, DAX queries, check out the video that's flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.